All right, we're here with Ryan from the SkyDrive team. So we're here to talk a little bit about another operating system we don't often talk about, but we do support. Tell us what you guys have worked out here.
Sure. We actually have versions of SkyDrive on kind of all the devices that people like to use, not just Microsoft devices.
Yeah.
So we know we have users that happen to use maybe an iPhone by chance. So we've actually had an iOS app out for about 2 years now. We haven't done a major update to it in a little while. And so this week, we're happy to kind of revamp the app with several new features that addresses a bunch of customer, I guess, feature requests that we've heard over the last few months, mm-hmm. as well as a whole new look and feel.
So it meshes with the iOS 7, right?
Yeah. That was one of the things that we wanted to do here was basically like take a step back and see how we could make our app look, feel a little more native and natural to iOS 7.
And how is this different from the app that we had before?
Basically, we've overhauled a couple things. So we have the new look and feel, so it fits in better with the OS. That includes larger thumbnails. We've also addressed a couple of top feature requests we've heard from customers. One of them is the ability to kind of automatically upload your photos and videos that you capture on the device with a feature we're calling camera backup. And then we've also enabled tighter integration with the Office Mobile for iPhone app that was released back in July, so that now you have the ability to natively edit Office files from the SkyDrive app in Office.
Cool. Can we take a look?
Yeah, let's do that. So from here, you can see this is my SkyDrive in the iOS app. We've added a new pivot down here on the bottom to basically take you to the camera backup feature. So here you can kind of see photos of my daughter, recent trip I took down to San Francisco and New York. And all of these get automatically uploaded as soon as I turn on the feature. We have a little status bar here at the top where it's basically saying everything's up to date. I have nothing pending. We really put users in control here so that they can decide if they want to include photos and videos, if they want it to work on a Wi-Fi network only or use their data plan, or even if they want to save space on their SkyDrive, we'll downsample the photos to a smaller size before they get uploaded. So that's camera backup, and we're super excited to bring this feature out to all of our iOS customers. This is something that we've had on Windows Phone from the beginning, and we know people love it there, and so we're excited to bring this to this platform as well. The next thing I want to show is our integration with Office Mobile on iPhone. So I'll go into my Documents folder here. We've always had this feature that's kind of native to the OS called Quick View. So this is me opening a Word document here in the iOS app. What we've done now is added an additional button here on the bottom that's an edit icon. And when I tap that, it'll go ahead and open this Word document right in the Office app so I can make edits and save directly back to SkyDrive. Yeah, it's pretty slick. And you can also choose to just open directly in Office and bypass the Quick Look view completely. So I think this combination of these two features is delivering a lot of value for our customers. We're really excited about it. It can light up some neat scenarios with the camera backup feature now in the new Xbox One app, so that you could be taking photos, having them automatically go to SkyDrive, and then show up on your living room TV
cool.
set.
Nice.
Yeah, so we're excited.
Awesome. Well, thanks for showing us this today.
Great. Thanks for having me.